We finished encoding our states in the burlap domain, so now let's add actions to the domain as well. To add actions to domain objects we generate, we can use a method built into the graph-defined-domain class, setTransition. This method is used to define both the set of actions and the transition function for the MDP. The first argument is an int, giving the ID of the state S we are transitioning from. The second argument is also an int, giving the ID of the action we are defining. I'll talk about that more in just a second. The third argument is an int giving the ID of the state T we are transitioning into. And the fourth argument is a double, giving the probability of transitioning to state T upon taking this action. Note that many different actions coming out of the same state can have the same ID, but the probabilities of the actions with the same ID leaving a given state must add up to 1. Looking at our state diagram again, if we want to define the action A, taking us from state 0 to state 1, we can call setTransition with the arguments 0 for the ID of the state we are leaving, 0, since this is the first action we're defining from state 0, 1, which is the ID of the state we're transitioning into, and 1. And I'm adding a decimal point to denote that this is a double. Since this is a deterministic action, with probability 1, we will always enter state 1 by taking action 0 from state 0. To define action B, we call setTransition with the arguments 0, again, because we are leaving state 0, 1, since this is going to be action 1 from state 0, 2, which is the ID of the state we are entering, and 1 dot, since, again, this is a deterministic action. With probability 1, this action will always take us from S0 to S2. Similarly, action C will be defined by calling setTransition with arguments 0, 2, since this is action 2 coming out from state 0, 3, for the ID of the state we're entering, and 1, since this is a deterministic action. Now let's put this into our code. Notice that I am casting this.dg, which is our domain generator object, to a graph-defined domain before calling setTransition. This is needed because setTransition is not defined for the domain generator class. Another point to notice is that we are defining all of these actions before we call this.dg.generateDomain. We're calling the setTransition functions first because it tells the graph-defined-domain object to include these transitions in its blueprint when it generates a new domain object. Calling generateDomain first would create a domain with 6 states, but no transitions, as I found out myself as I was learning to use BURLAP.